All of this has been about you. I've just lost my best friend and my baby because of you.
Me and Es were talking about pride.
These parades, they're not about equality, they're about being the centre of attention.
I'll be the best that I can be, but I can't be with you.
You need to choose who you want to be with. So either you tell her, or I will.
Oh, Tony, we have got so much planning to do for Hollyoaks Pride.
We thought you might like to intro the bands.
Bands? You told me it was a little do. For live music, you need special kind of permits.
Sorry, Tony, but it's going to take more than a little do to shake off your reputation.
Hey, those comments were taken completely out of context by you, Esther.
Well, we've got the uni LGBT group coming in later for lunch, so you just best watch that mouth of yours.
For lunch? Diane's got a doctor's appointment over lunch and Steve's called in sick. Harry, you've got a free period, haven't you? Do you want to stay now with your dad?
Sorry, I've got something I need to do.
What have you guys done to me, eh? And how can anyone who's seen Wicked three times be classed as homophobic?
Well, you better talk to them friends of yours at the council and get those permits. Because, babes, when it comes to Pride, you're either in or you're out.
Yeah, something smells surprisingly edible.
Yeah, well, it's a fresh start for all of us, so I thought I'd make everyone's favourite breakfast. So scrambled eggs for Portia, a kippers for you, and banana bongos for my little Cleo.
I'm not 10 anymore, Mum. Keep it sound good.
Right, suit yourself. Listen, do you know if Mum's got any herbs in the garden? I'm going to make it all posh like Nigella.
Look. Cleopatra, I was thinking about what you said yesterday. I really don't think now is the right time.
The longer we wait, the more we're going to end up hurting Mum. I can't keep this a secret anymore, Pete. I think that we should tell her today.
Hold up, Jace. I'm not sure I'm up for this after all.
Come on. I know you're upset about Leela, but a run's going to help clear your head.
I'm serious, mate. It's me groin.
Always is with you, innit? What's happening with this mystery woman?
I don't know. I don't think it's going to work out.
I know it's Tegan.
What?
Yeah, I worked that one out a little while ago. Look, you tried your best to sort things out with Leela. You can't punish yourself. And I know it's a little bit messy, but if you really like Tegan, mate, then you need to go for it.
You're right, Jess.
Listen, thanks, yeah? I'll see you later on.
Yeah. But hang on, she went that way!
Tony, you really don't have to keep doing this, you know. I'm still full of all that stew you made me last night.
Yeah, well, I'm going to keep feeding you until you're fighting fit. And my homemade granola bars are just a thing if you're feeling run down. Hey, where are the kids?
Oh, I'm sorry, they're playgroup.
Oh. Yeah, how's he doing?
Can I hear you?
Look, Steve, we know how much you're missing Hannah. But you need to keep your mind occupied. I mean, this gay pride thing's getting completely out of hand. Maybe there's something you can do, eh?
Oh, yeah. I'll just pop a post-it note on a big gay notice board, shall I?
Come on! You made breakfast, the least we can do is wash up.
Oh, my little 21st century man. So you can get a smile out of that one, will you?
Yeah, I'll do my best. Whoa.
Cleo,
Cleo, I've loved your mum for a long time. I care about her.
Not enough to tell her the truth.
Keep your voice down, please. Sweetheart, you have to see it from my side. What you're asking me to do is a life-changing thing.
I know. I hate all the sneaking around and lying. I just want to be able to walk down the street with you like a real couple.
So do I, my little Cleopatra. So do I. Nothing could make me happier. What me and you have, it's different. It's so special. But we have to be careful. Because people won't understand.
We could leave. We could go somewhere where nobody knows who we are.
No. We're not running away because we've done nothing to be ashamed of. Not telling your mum is the right thing to do, but I must be the person who does that, okay? I just need a little more time. So no more silly ultimatums, all right? All right?
All right.
Good girl. Right, you wash, I'll dry.
Oh, Tony, great you're back. We've just been brainstorming celeb guests. I mean, I know Ollie Murs.
He's cleaner, you know he's cleaner.
Look, guys, I've got some bad news. I've just been to talk to the events department of the council and they have vetoed our plans. Hollyoaks Pride is off. I'm just as gutted as you. I mean, I love Ollie Murs.
Well, we'll march on the council building? I mean, this is discrimination.
No, don't do that. Oh, I'm doing really good.
There's the LGBT group. I best go break the news.
I just hope they're feeling forgiven.
Oh, no. They're revolting.
That is exactly the kind of attitude that got you in this mess in the first place.
What?
Oh. Tony, this is Lucy Weeks. She's the president of the committee.
Wow. You're a president.
Yeah, why is that surprising to you?
No. I'm all for equality, whether it be for lesbians or women. Not that lesbians aren't women. Obviously, by definition, they are.
Mr. Hutchinson, I thought you asked us here because you wanted to make amends for your online slurs.
I did. I mean, I do.
Tony's no homophobe. I mean, he's seen Wicked more times than I have.
Yeah, and he's done everything he can to get Pride to happen, haven't you, Tony?
Yeah, absolutely everything. Look, I know it's disappointing, but why don't you stay and have a little bit of lunch? You know, I'll throw in some complimentary crudités and hummus for the homosexuals. That was offensive. I'm sorry, I'll just...
Oh! I am a mess.
Yeah, well, you've definitely seen better days.
And I'm probably gonna get fired. Missing my shift last night. And Perry never wants to see me again, and Ziggy, he hates me. I've got nothing left.
What's this about Ziggy?
He broke up with me yesterday. Just don't know what I'm gonna do, Ziggs.
We will sort all of this out, I promise. I'm gonna come back and check on you in a bit, okay? Just try and get some sleep.
I'm not sure I can. Oh, of course I want my job. Right. Yeah, I'll be there in 10. Okay.
Sounds like they're having fun out there.
Yeah, only because I keep plying them with food. Here, I'll taste this.
Oh, come on.
Huh? More salt?
No. That's good. Hey, what, I'll take you over now.
How'd your appointment go?
Do you know what? I couldn't find anything wrong with me. I felt like a right hypochondriac, reeling off all my symptoms. Anyway, they've taken some blood for further tests, so...
Probably just a bug or something.
Yeah.
Well, you might think you're a bigot, but at least you're a bigot that makes a lovely ghost cheese salad.
Hmm.
Oh, Auntie Diane, how did you get on at the docks?
Oh.
Diane?
What's happened?
Oh, it's okay. It's just a nosebleed. Get me some tissue.
You're pushing yourself too hard, that's why.
You shouldn't be in this sweaty kitchen. Come on, I'll get you home.
No, look, you're busy, okay? I'll be fine. Honestly, I just need to go home and put my feet up. Oh.
You shouldn't be here. I think about you every second of the day. I can't concentrate in school.
I don't want to hear that, do I?
Why? Can't you get it, Harry? This relationship has ruined my entire life. I've had my daughter taken away from me.
Yeah, but that's not all on me.
I know. Look, everything is a mess. I've got Diane and Tony feeling sorry for me, which I don't deserve. I don't know when, if I'm going to see Hannah again. Look, I've lost everything.
Well, not everything. Okay, you haven't lost me. Look, I've never felt this way about anyone before, Steve. And if you feel even half of what I feel, then you know, we'd be complete idiots to give up on it.
I'm sorry, I can't.
I will. It's worth a try.
I was gonna take this to go, but if you could use some company. Jack's looking after the baby, and I could really use a break. Yeah, sure. How is the little one anyway?
Loud.
And her poos are yellow.
That is so mean.
I know, I'm literally never gonna eat a hot dog with mustard ever again. Anyway, I'm so bored of all that stuff. Let's talk about something normal. Like, how's that guy you were seeing? The one with a girlfriend.
I know you're gonna think I'm a horrible person, but he is gonna leave her, for me.
Isn't that what men say in every film? And they never actually do it. Have you two, you know...
I think it'll be better once we're actually official. I know that sounds wrong. When you've got sisters like Portia and Celine, you just get used to being the invisible one. Honestly, it makes me feel so special. When it's just us two, it's like no one else exists. That's so cringy, isn't it?
Look, I know I don't have much experience with boys, but I do with people keeping secrets. And they always come out, Cleo. Just ask my mum.
What am I supposed to do? I can't force him to tell her, can I?
Why don't you just tell her yourself?
Tegan, I'm so glad you're here.
Tegan, wait.
No, listen. I broke up with Lily yesterday.
I heard.
And I just want you to know that I'm going to be there for her and the baby. It goes without saying. But ain't it about time that me and you had a bit of happiness, Teagues? So look, I've been looking at holidays. A couple of weeks in Italy. Just the two of us.
We can't. Not just the holiday. Us. It's going to push Leela over the edge.
How many times have we been through this, eh? There's always something or someone standing in our way, and now there's nothing. Besides, I've already bought myself a pair of white Speedos, and this gaff don't take refunds. So, is that a yes?
There is nothing that I want more. But what are we going to do about Leela? She's a wreck. I mean, I've seen her on benders before, but nothing like this.
Hang on, what? Has she been drinking? How can she do that to the baby? I mean, of all the irresponsible, stupid things.
Sorry, it's a hospital I've got to. Hello? Right, yeah, I'll be there straight away, thanks.
What?
It's Leela. She's been injured in a fire.
Yeah, I'm just getting back in now. Oh, will you please stop worrying about me? I've just been to place to pick up a few bits.
Trust me,
okay? I'm not gonna get off the sofa all day. I'll see you later.
Hi, babe.
Come watch this with me.
Mum, what happened yesterday with Pete?
Don't feel awful.
You can't treat him like that. He deserves better.
I love how protective you are over Pete. He's been like a dad to you girls. And you're right. He's too good for me. But somehow, and for some reason, he still loves me. Despite all my nonsense. That's why I'm going to do everything I can to make things right, OK? So were you anyway? You seem a bit distracted. Is it Harry?
No.
Come on. I can spot boy problems a mile off. Mum's instinct. But come on, then. Who's the lucky fella?
Am I interrupting?
No. Cleo was just about to tell me all about her new boyfriend.
Mum.
Oh, there's nothing to be ashamed of. We're queens. We can't help it if men flock to us.
Leave the poor girl alone. I'm sure she'll tell us when the time is right.
If every student had expensive taste like this lot, I'd never have to divide a single cheese toastie four ways again. We're going to clean up today.
Oh, this is nothing, this. I mean, you should see them at Pride. They make Wall Street look like Benefit Street.
Yeah, and it's such a pity you're never going to see the true power of the pink pound.
Pride could have been huge for you, you know, Tony, what with food, drinks, merchandise.
Excuse me.
Sorry to interrupt, but I've got an update on Pride. You know, I couldn't stand by and watch as my lesbian, gay, bisexual and, well, other brothers and sisters were discriminated against. Oh, no. So if you go down, I go down with you.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's been a tough old day of intense negotiations, but I have managed to turn the council round and we will have our Pride celebrations.
Yeah! This is all my fault.
Don't do that. She's a big girl. She knows better than to go into a building before it's safe.
But why are they letting her go into that fire when she's pregnant? Drinking. Putting her baby and her team in danger. That's not Leela. I pushed her to this point.
And I shouldn't have left her on her own when she was in that state. We can all blame ourselves, Zig.
But what kind of man leaves his wife when she's expecting his child? I tell you what, if anything happens to this baby, I will never forgive myself.
Your mum's still on one. She's gone out to buy ingredients for dinner. What was all that nonsense about a new boyfriend? You were going to tell her, weren't you?
It just felt like the right time.
That's not up to you, Cleo! If you want to be in a grown-up relationship, you better start acting like an adult, not some silly, lovesick little kid.
Sorry.
Do you even care what it would do to your mum if you told her about us? Are you that selfish?
Of course I care.
You saw her yesterday! You saw how she was struggling! Have you stopped to think how awful you would feel if we told her about us and she went off to do something stupid?
She wouldn't.
No? Do you really want to take that risk?
No.
Oh, I'm so lucky. Sorry for shouting. I'm just worried about your mum.
I'm sorry, I wasn't thinking straight. You do want to be with me, though, don't you, Pete? Because if you don't, then what we're doing is wrong.
Are you kidding me? Being with you is the only thing I think of. You're everything I want, Cleo. You believe me, right? Your mum's gonna be out a while. Why didn't I prove it to you?
I am sorry, okay? I'm so sorry.
You nearly Roger Federer's in the head.
I am so sorry.
Hey. What's up? Are you all right?
Someone was in the flat, okay? And it wasn't Steve or Tony. I don't know who it was because I text them.
Maybe you just thought you heard something. I mean, your mind's been all over the place. You've not been well.
So why can't the doctors tell me what's wrong with me then? Right, I've been looking up my symptoms.
Well, self-diagnosis is never a good idea, mind.
And guess what keeps coming up?
What?
Poisoning.
What?
Yeah. Feeling nauseous, getting nosebleeds, fatigue, and now paranoia.
Well, I mean, a mate of mine once got mercury poisoning from this old sushi diet thing that he was on.
What? Well, all I've eaten today was a...
What?
Do you know, he's always round here. Always trying to feed me, pushing for more time to spend with the kids. And with me out the way, he'd get sole custody, wouldn't he? And it all makes perfect sense.
I'm sorry, I'm lost.
Tony? I think Tony's been trying to poison me.
Tiggs, we're never going to be together, are we?
No. Dr. Savage.
Yes. Leela's going to be fine. A piece of wood had lodged itself in her side, so we had to put her under to remove it. But the procedure was successful, and her vital signs are all normal. She's a very lucky girl.
Okay, now what about the baby?
I'm sorry?
Well, the baby's fine too, right?
I'm sorry, Ziggy, there is no baby.
Tonight, Chatty Man has Selena Gomez in and Kristen Wiig talks about The Martian. Alan Carr, stand and deliver. Thank you at 10. Now, pull the date of your dreams and how. E4 will show you the way to get the hotties and naughty would be nice. That's Tuesday at 10:30.
I can't believe Diane didn't see us.
No. I haven't been that terrified since I was all Wizard of Oz as a kid. Do you remember them flying monkeys?
Was it always going to be like this? Sneaking around, trying not to get caught.
Yep.
It's exciting, isn't it?